Hello guys and welcome to my channel. This is the PIP video in this series, and in this video I will be showing you that how to make a Python authentication system which can be used with Flutter as well as web. Now without wasting any more time, let's get started. Now let me clear one thing here. This is just a simple authentication system. You can build a very complex authentication system for your Flutter app, but this is just for explanation purpose. That's why I create this simple authentication system. Now first of all, go to the description box and here you will find a link, a GitHub repo link. Go to that GitHub link and download the whole project. Now here you will find a readme file. Now the readme file consists of pip commands and various link for testing purpose. Now first of all, copy those two line of code, which is pip install flask and pip install SQL alchemy, and paste that in your terminal, and these two library will be installed on your machine. If you are using virtual environment, then those two library will be installed on your virtual environment. Now first of all, import these two libraries which we installed a few seconds ago. Now here first of all, I am creating an app variable, and here I am passing flask underscore underscore name underscore underscore. Now what it means, it's is an instance of flask, and here I am passing underscore underscore name underscore underscore, and this is for the file name. If you don't understand the meaning of underscore underscore name underscore underscore, then you can check on the internet. Now this line of code is for configuring our database so that we can use our database and specify the location where our database will be saved. Now I am saving my database on the desktop, that's why I place the desktop location. Now here in the next line, I am creating a db variable, and here I am passing SQL alchemy, and then I am passing here an app instance which is a plus instance. Now here I am doing this because so that we can link our db with our flask app. Now here I am creating a class user, and then I am passing db.model. Now this user will be stored in our database. Now first of all, I am creating here a columns, and you can see that I am creating columns for ID, username, email and password. You can use different field if you want, but I am here using ID, username, email and password. And as you can see here that I am using db.column to create column for that, and here I am also specifying db.string, db.integer to specify the type of data which we will be stored, and then here in the round bracket we will be also specifying how much will be the length of the item that we will be storing in that specific column. Now here in app.root I am creating my first root which will be login, and here this root will accept two methods. The first one will be get method and the second one will be post method. As you already know that whenever the user go to localhost/login, then this function will be called. Now here in this function I define these few lines, and here first of all I am creating an empty dictionary so that we can store our status code here, response code here. Then I will be checking if the request dot method is equal to post. It's mean if the user did a post request, then this line of code will execute, this block of code will execute. Now here I am getting the username and the password from the form. Now here we are creating login variable, and then we are using user.query.filterby, and then passing the username and the password that we get from the form, and then here I am saying .post. Now what it means that it is querying our database to check if the username and the password is already exist, and then we are getting the post result. Now here I am using .post method, but it is not necessary here as we will be only create one account at one username. It's mean that our username will be unique for each user, so we don't need to use .post method. Now here I am checking app login is not none. It's mean that we found a matching account and will be respond with status code 11, and here I am passing the dictionary jsonify.d to make it a JSON. Now if the login is none, then else block will run, and it's mean that account not found or account not exist, and hence we will be responding with status code 22. Now that's all for login. Now here I am creating a register root, and here it will also accept post and get method. Now here first of all I am creating here an empty dictionary which we will be using later in responding. Now here first of all I am here checking if the method is a post request, And then here I am getting the username, mail and password from the form, from the register form. In the first we are getting the username and password from the login form, and here we are getting these values from the register form. And here in the next line I am using user.query.filterby, and here I am passing username.first. Now what it means that if a username is already exist or not. Now if the username is already exist, then username will be not none. Now if the username is none, it means that username with that specific username is not already exist in our database, and then we can proceed with the following block of code. Now first of all I am creating here register, and then here I am creating instance of user class, and then passing the username, mail and password that we get from the register form. And then in the next line I am creating a session, db.session.addRegister, and I am adding the register to our db. And then in the third line we are committing the session, committing the changes that we made to our database so that new user is successfully saved to our database. And now we will need to respond with status code 11 so that the user know that they have successfully registered. Now if the username is not none, then it's mean that the following else block of code will run, and it's mean that account already exists. So we will be responding with status code 22. Now here at last I am saying app underscore underscore name underscore underscore is equal to underscore underscore main. It's mean that if we directly execute this code from terminal, this line of code will run. And here in the first line I am saying db.createAll to create database for our model. Now at the last line we are saying app.run to run our app, and then here I am setting debug is equal to true so that it is started in debug mode, so that we can debug it easily. Now here you can also specify port if you want to run it on a certain port, but here I am not specifying the port number, so it will run on the default port. Now our authentication system is ready, and now we need to run our Flask server. Now to run your Flask server you need to specify flask and then app.py. Now if you are Windows user, then you don't need to specify Python 3, you can just run it by python app.py. I don't know exactly, but that will work fine I think. Now in the terminal result you will see that running on localhost port 5000, and this is the default port for Flask server. If you specify the port number, then that will be available on that port. Now here on the screen you can see that database.db is created successfully, and now we can request queries to our database. We can create user in our database. Now if you check readme file from my project, then you will find here these two testing commands, and the first testing command is for registering a new user from a terminal. Now copy that command and paste it in terminal, and if you read the command then you will find that I am passing username, email and password. And if we press enter, then we will be getting status code 11, and that is because a user with that username is not already existed, and hence we create new user in our database. Now if we copy the same code for the second time and paste it in our terminal, then we will be getting status code 22, and that is because the username is no longer unique. It is already existed in our database, and that's why our code will not let us create in other user with the same username. Now copy and paste the command for the third time in terminal and change the username. And you will find that it will returning a status code 11, and that is because user with that username is not already exist, and that's because it's create the user, the third user successfully. Now let's us check the login by testing this command. Now here in the login you will find that I am only forcing the username and the password. You can also use the mail and password, but here in my code I specify that I will be using username and password. That's why I create here username and password. And here as you can see that it's written as the status code 11, and that is because username and password is already existing in my database. Now if we just type randomly or type username and password,
then it will not return the status code 11, and that is because of that username and password is not existed in my database. Now that's all for this video, and in the next video I'll be showing you that how to use this simple authentication system for your Flutter app. Thank you guys, thanks for watching.